let me tell you about our very special guest judge. She is the editor-in-chief of Family Circle magazine. Please give a warm welcome to Linda Fears. Welcome, Linda.
It's great to see you.
Welcome, my darling.
Thank
you. Look
you.
Gorgeous. Nice to see you.
Great to welcome. Be here.
The best overall platter from today's winning team will be featured in an upcoming issue.
I think this is amazing. 18 million people read this magazine. Like, this is really big.
Let's start off with 4th of July, red team. Let's go, please. Kristen and Jackie, thank you.
Chef Ramsay and guest judge Linda Fears will award a point to each dish they deem worthy, giving each holiday platter a potential score of 3 points.
Wow.
I'm like, is that a fucking hot dog with apples on it?
The hot dog, a beer poached sausage with a pickled red onion and apple.
The apple isn't really working for me.
Ugh.
Not worthy of a one.
No. Next, please.
In the center, there's a cheeseburger with apple slaw.
You got apple twice.
Yeah, a little bit of theme.
Right, let me cut the burger for you.
Burger's
okay,
it's
raw.
A little
under. Damn, I'm sorry. I'm not going to let you eat that. I'm so okay. Sorry. Can you imagine a raw burger in a magazine, ladies?
Sorry, chef.
Dude, like, why would you give him a raw burger? What's wrong with you?
Wow. Next up, ladies.
We have grilled corn with a little bit of a garlic jalapeno aioli.
That's nice. That's a nice kick.
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty.
It is pretty.
Fucking kidding me?
Finally, we have some
yes.
flavor. Worthy of a point?
Yes.
It's just corn, but you're lucky because it's delicious corn. Take it back, please. 1 out of 3.
You grilled some fucking corn.
I did the corn.
And now, Boston line cook Christian and Mary the Butcher from Belchertown, Massachusetts.
I have for you a pan.
Oh, Jesus.
I have for you.
That's much better.
Pan-seared duck breast
with a red wine and orange reduction.
Wow, where are you cooking?
I'm a butcher at a market in Amherst, Massachusetts.
The duck is still raw in the middle. You've got that white line of fat underneath, and the duck is chewy. So insufficient resting, but it's not even cooked properly.
I'm sorry, chef.
Well, congratulations, you certainly butchered your dish. Now, what is that?
It's called pasta alla norma, sautéed eggplant with garlic, and it's topped with basil and shaved ricotta salata.
And where did you get the majority of your line experience?
I bounced around through mom and pop shops in the north end of Boston.
Mm-hmm. I mean, it looks a mess, but it's got flavor, and you've got heart and passion in there.
Thank you, sir.
One to the men. Congratulations, well done.
Thank
Good.
You.
4 to 4. Final pairing. Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready?
Ladies and gentlemen, it's the final round, and we have a tie. Now, headline cook Zach from Philadelphia will face roundsman Jacqueline from Florence, New Jersey.
Let's go. Right. Big boy, what is that?
That's grilled pork chop with mustard greens.
And your position is?
Just line cook.
Don't just dish a line cook as a line cook. I mean, that's where head chefs are made on
right.
the line, right?
Nice stuff.
Mm-hmm. I mean, combination with the apple, fig. The dish tastes nice. Unfortunately, the protein, mm-hmm. yeah, is slightly dry.
What about the flavor?
I said it tastes nice.
Thank you, chef. Thank you, chef.
The question for me is Jacqueline's better? Because it all comes down to this.
Okay, I have a roasted magre duck breast with a sweet potato roasty and caramelized Brussels sprouts with the currant au jus.
Seasoned beautifully, presented. Nice. This is really close. Both dishes have got great execution, presentation, beautiful.
Yes, thank you.
Both holding finesse. We definitely finished better than we started. But this is really tough, I'm telling you. Your dishes are going to decide who's going to win the first challenge.
Ooh.
This is hard. Duck. Could have done with 2 minutes more, and the pork chop could have done with 2 minutes less. Oh dear. The winning team. Congratulations. Ladies, great job.
Good afternoon, Jason.
Good to see Paul again.
Great to see Paul.
All right, so here we have stuffed halibut with goat cheese, crab, and shrimp.
Is that spaghetti underneath, or it's just?
Yeah, some capellini.
I don't really get the capellini, to be honest with you. I think it just looks like you threw something on the plate just to add a starch. It's just very plain and boring.
Paul's a dick, all right? He was a dick on season 9, and he's still a dick.
Rock, out of 5, how would you judge Jason's dish, please?
I'm gonna give you a 3.
Dana, how did that taste?
Everything's kind of coated in a lot of butter.
Yeah, not thought out properly.
I'm gonna go with a 2.
Sorry. Paul, please.
I'm sorry, man, I'm gonna go 1.
1, wow.
1? Paul's gonna fuck himself.
For me, it's a 2 as well.
All right, well, thank you all for your input. I really do appreciate it, thank you. Wah, wah, wah.
Jason, let's confirm one thing. You'll definitely not be the month of December.
Thanks, chef.
You're welcome. Keisha, let's go, please.
Here I have a rack of lamb covered with a honey pistachio demi that denim I did.
Say it again.
Demi.
I'm just nervous. Basically, it's all about Rock, because I was like, oh my God, is he really here? Is this really happening to me?
You're from the north, right?
No, I'm from the south. I'm from Mississippi.
I'm joking.
Rock, what do you think?
Visually, I like it. I like the color balance.
Mm-hmm. Danny, what do you think?
The lamb for me looks a little bit undercooked.
It is, you're absolutely right.
You have the sweetness of the sauce, but it just needs something to contrast it.
You're just missing something.
It needs one more item on there just to bring it together.
I had squash, however, they got soggy, so I didn't want to present that to you all.
Dana, how would you judge that out of 5?
I'm gonna give it a 3.
Paul?
I also give it a 3.
Rock?
3 as well, yeah.
I'm not gonna be as generous, I'm gonna go 2. Thank you.
Thank you all so much.
Damn, what a shame.
You got to stand next to Rock. You wanted to rub his head.
Next up, Rochelle, please. Thank you.
Hello, chefs.
Vibrant.
I have a New York seared over cilantro lime chimichurri sauce. I was thinking colors and flavors. I wanted to kind of like excite your mouth and your eyes.
Rock, how was that for you?
Flavor is there. I'm gonna give it a 4.
Thank you.
The flavors were there, but the plating is a little bit sloppy. I'm gonna give it a 3.
For me, the star of the dish was the chimichurri sauce. I'm gonna give it a 3.
3? Interesting. Chimichurri lifts that dish and makes it for me. However, you haven't rendered the fat down properly, so you've got that raw fat, which is unappetizing. I don't want to see raw fat in a photograph. For me, it's a 3. Thank you.
13 out of 20. That's like 65%. That's actually not that good, but better than everybody else so far. Honestly, we kind of need to pick it up a bit.
Good effort, Rochelle. But unfortunately, you can't put raw fat on a calendar. What were those first 3 dishes, let me tell you? Holy shit.
No, we'll find one, chef.
We'll find one? Paul, help me, help me, help me.
That's what I'm here for.
And now Anthony has the chance to clinch the victory.
Today I've made something very simple, something I'd eat with my nena.
Oh.
It's a grilled chicken. Underneath is pinto beans that I've refried.
The chicken was like really good. I liked it tender. The only thing that I think that I would fix is like to add a little bit more flavor to it.
Absolutely. Brianna, really, like you're 15. What do you know about the flavor of chicken?
Very well prepared. Like you said, it reminds me of something that we'd have at home. Overall, very good.
Mary, please present the dish.
I prepared for you a butterfly chicken breast with a lemon cream sauce and a cauliflower puree.
I like the flavor that you used, but I kind of felt it a little too soft.
I love the lemon in it.
Really, really flavorful, but the sauce has a little bit too much lemon.
Joseph, I'm gonna start with you.
The score right now is 2-1. We have to get this point or we're gonna go down in flames.
I'm gonna go with the red team.
Red team. Jennifer.
I'll go with the blue team.
And finally, my darling.
I like both of them. They were really good. But I'd have to go with the red team.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Way to go, Mary.
Good job. Point to the red team.
Whew, that was close. All right, girls, come on now. We still got a good fighting chance here.
We're tied. It all comes down to the last dish. Let's see the steak.
All right, Amanda. Come on, babe.
Come
Come on, guys. Let's get this one, please. Could take another fucking loss.
I mean, we've won just one challenge. We need this so bad.
I made a grilled ribeye with some spicy chili peppers, but nothing overpowering.
The flavor was really good.
Thank you.
It was delicious.
Yeah, I'm back.
Michael, please.
Brianna really enjoyed Amanda's dish, but my flavors are spot on. I really don't think there's any comparison.
Wow.
Is that blood?
Yeah.
Is it raw?
No, chef.
It did taste a little raw.
Definitely undercooked.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely right.
Brianna does not like the undercooked.
Sorry about the blood on the plate.
I don't even know what to think anymore. I guess I can't cook steak. I fucking give up already.
Prefer the red team or blue team?
Red team.
Red team. Red team.
Red team. Well done. Another point to the red team.
Thank you.
Congratulations. Great job.
What the fuck am I saying anymore?
We were so close. It's just another demoralizing blow for the blue team.
Jennifer, Josette, and Brianna, these winning dishes are going on the menu. Thank you for your feedback. I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. Yeah.
Thank you.
Ladies, 7 out of 8 challenges. Total domination. Great job. Right, first up, Amanda and Joe. Let's go, please.
In this duck challenge, Chef Ramsay and Chef Citron will each judge the dishes on a scale of 1 to 4.
Joe.
All right, Joe.
As their scores will be combined, the maximum a dish can score is 8 points.
How you doing, Chef? Good afternoon.
How you doing?
The first pair of chefs to face off is Amanda and Joe. His duck dish features
bok choy and a basmati rice tamale, kind of.
Tamale.
Yes.
To me, it looks like a spring roll and a tamale.
Yeah, bok choy roll, tamale.
Exactly.
Tamale? Really, bro? Like, really?
This actually tastes pretty good.
But it's not Mexican.
No chef.
Let's get that right.
I'm going to go with a 3.
I love the flavors. 3 for me.
Thank you, chef.
It would be so much better had you not mentioned that word tamale.
Joe, what the hell are you thinking? Come on, wake up.
Amanda.
Very overcooked, the duck.
Do you know it's overcooked, Amanda?
Yeah. Mm.
Tastes like pork.
Yeah, it's very mealy.
Ugh, this is not good. I hate disappointing Chef Ramsay.
Way off.
Everything's off.
Way overcooked.
One.
Yeah, one
Sorry,
as well.
Chef.
Amanda, terrible. Red team, what a shame.
That a boy, Joe, that a boy.
While the men celebrate an early lead.
Ariel and Chad, please, let's go.
Chad puts up his duck breast with pomegranate jus.
Looks clumsy.
The flavors are good. I'll give this one a 3.
2 for me.
Against Ariel's duck breast with pomegranate glaze.
Please. Give this one a 3 as well.
Yeah, 2. 5 each. Underwhelming, what a shame. Jackie and Frank, please, let's go.
With the men still in the lead, Jackie's attempt at a wax bean puree.
There's no finesse on this at all.
Scores just 5 points, while Frank's wax bean risotto impresses.
Very nice.
Bit of a chef's dream.
I have to go 4 here.
3 for me. Solid 7. Well done, Frank.
Good job, Frank.
Cooking a duck takes methods, technique, and understanding of how to cook the bird.
Right, next up, Danny and Alan.
Come on, Alan.
With the women trailing by 6 points, Danny hopes to close the gap with her duck and sautéed collard greens.
Love those collard greens. 3 for me.
Let's overcook the duck. I will give this one a 2.
Against Alan's deep-fried collard greens.
It's greasy, it's bland, it's swimming in water.
There's nothing exciting, so I will just give this one a 1.
I agree. 1. Not good, Alan.
With the women still trailing, Mies is looking to get a leg up.
I don't understand using the duck leg without the proper time to cook it.
No.
When you have a beautiful breast.
With her unconventional choice of cut.
That's not as tough as I would imagine, bro.
No, you're absolutely right.
Yeah, I'm going to give it a 2.
Oh, I'm a 2.
While Hassan has high hopes for his duck breast with cabbage ragu.
I know it looks visually appalling, but I think the flavors will be good.
I'm struggling. A 1.
Yeah,
chef.
I agree, a 1.
Thank you, chef.
Men, 22. Red team, 21.
With the women catching up and only 2 rounds left.
Eddie, Ashley, let's go.
Come on, Eddie.
Come on, Ed.
Eddie has pulled out all the stops with his
pan-seared duck breast tossed with garlic, cipollini, onion.
Oh, dear. We would be shut down.
Lose your stars right away.
Well, a customer can actually choke on that. Raw white fat, that.
Damn it.
We would get shut down if we were to send a duck breast caked in fat like that out.
No one eats it when it's like that.
Raw fat.
Like, come on, bro. That is raw fat. And when you're in Hell's Kitchen, you can't be that dumb.
Mmm, shame. The sprouts are delicious.
Yeah, our flavors are good. Mm.